Amen.
So today we are going we continued, or we are going to continue from where we ended yesterday. Remember, we said one of the things that can delay you is sin. And so today we are going to continue and look at what are some of the ingredients that can delay us so far as our destiny is concerned. And so can we share with a prayer? Father, in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
We thank you for the privilege to gather and to hear your word and to stand upon your word to pray. Our fervent prayer is that, Lord, as we stand before you, may we be worthy to come before you in prayer.
Yes,
we thank you for the TPMI family. We thank you for the Prayer Rain family, the Wind of Deliverance family.
Yes,
we thank you for each one of them that are gathered to hear and to pray with us. It is our fervent prayer that their time will not be wasted.
Yes.
Lord, use this avenue to encourage somebody who is on the verge of giving up, somebody who has given up, somebody who is tired of life, depressed, frustrated, sick, dejected. I pray that you will use us as a conduit to come to them live in their home, in the comfort of their bed, with the prayer ring, that they will be touched,
yes,
that they will be transformed,
yes,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
That at the end of God, all glory and all honor shall be given unto your name.
No.
Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we love you. Jesus, we appreciate you. In the name that is above every other name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. And somebody will say a big amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
3-0. Now, ladies and gentlemen, God richly bless you once again. God bless you. God bless you. Now, we're going to look at another ingredient that delays us. Another ingredient that can delay us is our foundation. Somebody say foundation. Now, foundation is one of the series we'll be going to be doing in the prayer ring, where we're going to look at a whole week devoted to deal with foundation. So I'm not going to belittle the point by stretching it, because this is just to exhort you so that we can pray. Now, I have always told people that your foundation is very important. I remember when I went to school, even till today, there are people who speak some kind of English language. Sometimes when I see people make grammatical errors, especially in grammar, or their inability to, you know, spell a word well and be fluent, sometimes, or most of the time, is because of the foundation.
Yes.
Because I got to business school and I had colleagues and mates who were speaking English, and they were very fluent in the English. And to be very sincere, I was wondering if I was in the same class with them. But the reason was because I didn't blame them. Some of them, they went to very good schools. Their parents gave them very good foundations. Some of them went to very astute, you know, international schools. They went to, you know, secondary school, some school abroad, some school in Ghana. But they went to very good schools. So you notice that when you get a good foundation, your broad perspective about life changes.
Yes.
And so foundation is important. It is the desire of every parent to give their child a very good foundation, because once you can get a good foundation, it helps you. And so foundations are very important. That is why we are all not the same. But you see, one thing beautiful about God is that once you become born again and you accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, something about your life changes. It doesn't even matter about your foundation. God rewires your foundation, reworks on you, and brings you to a place where even your foundation doesn't speak anymore, because Christ has laid another foundation for you. And so foundations are very important. Foundations are very, very important and crucial. Now, if you look at even a building, okay, if you take a building, this building that we are in, bringing you the live service from, the live prayer ring from, what makes this building is not how the architectural design is molded. It's not about the design, no. In the UAE here, I've seen very, very, very beautiful building by God's grace. But one day I was passing, you know, one of the mosques around Aguada, and I saw how they do their building, and I realized that is why they could do 13 floors, 14 floors, you know, 70 floors and the rest. Because I realized that they pay very much attention to the foundation. So a building is not nice or just the beauty of it, but it is the foundation of the building that makes the building.
Yes.
And so you can have a very nice building, okay, but I want to tell you that the most important part of the building is the foundation of the building. No matter how magnificent or beautiful the building is, if the building, you don't pay attention to the foundation of the building, it is only a matter of time that the building will eventually collapse. And so it is important that you start, when it comes to foundation, you lay a firm foundation, a strong foundation, and not a faulty foundation. Because if you don't lay a strong foundation, eventually or imminently, the building is going to collapse. It's going to collapse. Whether it takes 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, eventually it's going to collapse. Well, this building we are in, if you enter right now, it looks very beautiful. But the last time I checked, I'm told that this building is over, was built around 1970, 1950 or something. But they have been able to maintain it till 2021. It tells you that it has a very strong foundation. You understand what I'm saying? So if you have a strong foundation, it will sustain you. Okay. And so I want you to understand that the structure can be glorious, but it will crumble if the foundation is not well done. And so Jesus gave us one parable which tells us the importance of foundation. And Jesus spoke about two men who went to build. And Jesus said, one built on a firm foundation. And when the wind came, the storm came, the rain came, the building was able to be sustained. But the Bible said that the one who built on a shaky foundation, he built with sand, he built with very shoddy materials. The Bible says that when the wind came and the sun came, and the wind came, the rain came, the building couldn't sustain. Now, what it means is that this can be translated into our lives as believers. The wind there represents the challenges of life. The wind there represents your background, your foundation, and other things that are fighting you from your background. And so if your foundation is not built solid in Christ, I am telling you, ladies and gentlemen, it is only a matter of time. That is why those people, I know believers, I know some Christians, their father was a believer, their mother was a believer, and so when they were growing up, they were given strong Christian virtues.
Yes.
They were taught the word of God, they had devotion with their parents, they were taught the scriptures, they went to church with their parents, so it was very easy for them to grow in an environment where they knew Christ, and so their foundation was solid. Some of us, we grew up in a foundation where our parents were not believers, our parents were idol worshippers, our parents were people who like to have fun, have party, go to the club, drink, smoke. And so there are people who even their parents raped them, took advantage of them, because there's no fear of God in their parents. And so their foundation that was built for them was a faulty foundation. I pray for somebody who is hearing me, that may God correct every faulty foundation in your life.
Amen.
Any foundation that is faulty, that is shaking, because you have come into Christ, may that faulty foundation be cancelled in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, many of us come from faulty foundations. Many of us, I'm telling you as listeners, many of us come from faulty foundation. I'm going to give you an example, and a typical example is Abraham. Abraham came from a very faulty foundation, and it delayed Abraham. How did it delay Abraham? It delayed Abraham because Abraham's wife, Sarah, could not bear him a child. He could not bear him a child. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Until God had to change his name, until God had to change the name of the wife, until God had to come, because Abraham came from a foundation where his father was an idol worshiper. Now, many people talk about Abraham and the promised land and how God was a friend to Abraham and all that. But many people don't talk about Abraham's father. You will not believe it. If you're a Bible student, you will notice that God gave the same promise to Abraham's father. That is why I tell people all the time that your age does not determine your success in life. Your age does not determine your progress in life. I'm telling you, your age does not determine. It is your ability to be able to break your cage in this life that you are able to receive your wages in life.
Amen.
And so if you don't understand the mystery behind your misery, you will still live in misery. It is your ability to discover that makes you to be able to recover. If you don't discover, you can never recover. So I am telling you, ladies and gentlemen, that if you are watching me and you come from a faulty foundation like Abraham, the father was an idol worshiper, and the only way God could intervene was to come to Abraham and tell Abraham that I need to move you out. Come out from thy kindred, the first one. Come out from thy kindred, come out from thy village, come out from thy city. God had to move Abraham out. May God move you out.
Amen.
May I pray for you. May God move you out from that foundation, that faulty foundation, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May every faulty foundation in your life, may God move you out. Because God had to intervene in the life of Abraham. He said, come out from thy kindred, come out from thy village, and come out from thy nation. I pray for somebody. May your foundation be corrected in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May every faulty foundation be corrected in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Another person who had a very faulty foundation was Jacob. Jacob had a faulty foundation because his fathers, Abraham, Isaac, all of these people had faulty foundation. And so the foundation of Jacob did not start from him. It started from his fathers. And the Bible said even his name was called Jacob, which means a defrauder or somebody who was very cunning. That was his name. And so the name Esau was a wrong foundation for Jacob. So he became a supplanter until he had an encounter with the angel of the Lord, and his name was changed from Jacob to Israel. And so there are many people who are grabblers, they are manipulators, they are cheats, because they have a wrong, faulty foundation. If you look at even the story about Jacob, his mother Rebecca was even an accomplice in ensuring that, you know, they steal the blessing of Esau. And so, ladies and gentlemen, you see some people, their life is full of deceit. Their life is full of fake life. You understand what I'm saying? They are thieves. I don't know if you've seen people like that. Their life is never straightforward. They can come to church, but still their life is not straightforward. They can lie. They are corrupt. They are fraudsters. They are manipulators. They are drunkards. They like women. There are people who, anything that they see is scared, they have to sleep with. I'm telling you, they have a faulty foundation to the point that anything they see is scared, they have to go into the pant of that person. And so, you have to do a spiritual mapping. Somebody say spiritual mapping.
Spiritual
you mapping. Have to do a spiritual mapping and be able to find out what is it, what foundation am I coming from that is delaying me? What foundation am I coming from? So that you can lay a strong foundation in Christ. Am I speaking to somebody?
Yes.
It is important that you lay a strong foundation in Christ. It is very important. And so many people are struggling because of their faulty foundation. And so I pray for you that may you have an encounter with God.
Amen.
So that any foundation that is delaying you, God will intervene like Jacob. The Bible said the angel touched what Jacob considered as his strength. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, I met somebody some time ago, and the person said, for me, I know how to convince people. And he was a fraudster. And Jacob was also a fraudster. So guess what God did? When God sent the angel of the Lord, God allowed the angel to touch the very sensitive part of Jacob. His strength, what Jacob considered as his strength, which he was using to defraud people. So I pray that anything that is your weakness, you understand? Anything that is your weakness, I pray that as we pray this morning, may God touch your weakness.
Amen.
Okay, any foundation you are coming from which has become a weakness in your life. Everybody has a weakness. Some people, their weakness is their anger. Some people, their weakness is their inability to forgive others when they are hurt. Some people, their weakness is that they are manipulators. Some people, their weakness is that they like women. They like to drink. They like to party. They are weak in that area. You understand what I'm saying? And so, I pray for you as a child of God. I pray for you. I really pray for you that in this prayer session, God, in his own infinite mercy, will touch your weakness in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May your weakness be touched in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May anything that has become a weakness in your life, may it be touched by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And so, you realize that when God was able to visit Jacob, Jacob's foundation was turned for good. God gave him a fresh heart. God gave him a fresh beginning. Child of God, listen to me. God is still in the business of giving us fresh beginnings.
Yes.
I pray for somebody who is listening. May God give you a fresh beginning.
Amen.
May God move you out of that crooked life.
Yes.
There are people who their life is never straightforward. They have a very crooked life. May God move you out of that crooked life.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May the Lord move you out.
Yes.
I said, may the Lord move you out.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And may God give you a fresh start.
Yes.
So that anything that has delayed in your life as a result of a faulty foundation, may God help you out of it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because when Jacob had an encounter with the angel of the Lord, his life was never the same. It affected him in his family. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so God wants to touch your life this morning. He wants to touch your character. Some of you know this. You understand? You tell people that that is how me I am. That is not how God created you. I'm telling you, God will not create you with a very bad habit or a bad character. God created you not with a bad character. There are some people, they have very bad character.
Yes.
And that is why God wants to take away that weakness and give you a fresh start in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And most of the time, when we are talking about foundations also, it is our actions and our inactions that becomes the totality of our foundation. So, as you are watching me and listening to me, what actions are you taking so far as your life is concerned? You see, a lot of people don't understand that you take advantage of somebody. Let's assume you took advantage of somebody, you raped somebody. It's an action you have taken, and you will pay for that action. So if you rape somebody, you've laid the foundation of rape in your family. If you are somebody who you go and lie on somebody, an innocent person, you've laid the wrong foundation. You sleep with somebody's wife, you have laid the wrong foundation. You sleep with somebody's husband, you've laid the wrong foundation, which can be done to you in this life, or it could be done to your children. Every action we take, whether you lie on somebody, gossip about somebody, the decision to do something to hurt somebody is a foundation you are laying. And that foundation will speak, because I told you that every action comes with a reaction. For God is not mock. Whatsoever a man soweth, he will reap.
Yes.
So whatever you do in this life, you will get it. One day, a child was going somewhere with a father and a grandfather, and they were going to put the grandfather in a homeless institute. And the grandfather kept crying and saying, "Oh, please, I don't want to go. I want to stay rather with you." And the father said, "We still have to take you to the homeless, we still have to take you to the aged home." As they took the man to the aged home and they were returning, the child was very quiet in the car. So the father asked him out of curiosity, "Why are you quiet?" And the child said, "Well, I'm just thinking about when you also grow old, I'm going to take you to." So I wanted to understand that in this life, whatever you do in this life, you will pay for it. If it is good, you will earn the fruit of goodness. If it is wickedness, you will earn the fruit of wickedness. And so a lot of people take actions without thinking twice. You did an abortion. You didn't think about that abortion, that is blood guilt. You know, we take actions without thinking twice. We do things against somebody without thinking twice. But we forget that for every action, there is a reaction. For every ungodly action that you take, you will pay for it. And I want to tell you, child of God, that foundations are very important. If you lay a right foundation, you will move like a speed of light in life. For instance, a lot of people want to get married. But you see, the marriage is not a competition. It's not a competition. Lay the right foundation. If you are dating this person and the person is having sex with you, that is the foundation you have laid. So tomorrow when you get married and he's cheating on you, don't talk. Because you laid a wrong foundation of lust before you got married. So therefore, foundations are important. What kind of foundation are you laying to your children? What are you teaching your children? Foundations are important. It is not how beautiful the wedding is. People today do very gargantuan wedding with about 10 to 20 bridesmaids and all that, with a tall cake and all that. It's unnecessary. It's about foundation. If you are able to lay a strong foundation, then you'll be able to accelerate in life. And so be sure of the foundation you are raising. Be very sure of the foundation you are raising. Now, a lot of people raise very faulty foundation, causing people pain, falsifying documents, falsifying their names, changing their date of birth, just to get a document, just to do things. Whatever you are doing today, you will pay for it tomorrow. So be careful of the foundations you are laying. Hallelujah. That is why a minister of state will do the wrong thing, then forgets that tomorrow he'll be a minister. And when he goes and is being interviewed, they are asking questions about his past. He can't give answer because he has laid the wrong foundation. So before you give a wrong identification, wrong name, because you want to travel, think about the foundation you are raising. Hallelujah. Amen. There are people out of greed. They want to be rich overnight. They want to be famous overnight. They lay wrong foundations of consulting oracles, consulting false prophets, consulting things, just because they want to be famous, they want to have money, they want to have power. And so you are laying the wrong foundation that can delay you rather in future, because you want a big business, you want whatever. All these things are wrong foundation you are laying. And you may not see it at the time you are raising it, but eventually it's going to fight you and it's going to be the source of your delay in life. And so many people are delayed in life as a result of a faulty foundation. I pray and I prophesy.
I receive it.
That may God help you out of a faulty foundation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May God help you and help your children out of a faulty foundation so that you can be able to press forward in life in the precious name of Jesus. We are going to pray. Amen. We are going to stand upon the word of the Lord. You remember what David did? He raised a wrong foundation. What is the wrong foundation that David raised? David slept with somebody's wife, took somebody's wife, killed the husband. David took somebody's wife, conspired and killed the man just because of a beautiful woman by laying the wrong foundation. What David did, I'm telling you, he couldn't pay for the consequences. The consequences were too much for him. His own children, because of what David did, his own children betrayed him. His own children were willing to kill him because of the foundation that he raised. And so we are going to pray this morning. We are going to pray this morning. We are dealing with foundations in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are going to be dealing with a very faulty foundation. That any foundation in your life that has delayed you, today as we pray, we are going to deal with that foundation in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And so I wanted to open your mouth and begin to pray. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank the Lord for the revelation of the word that has come. Thank Him for the revelation. 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 That Lord, we thank You for the word that has come. We thank You for this prayer ring program. We thank You for using it as a blessing to touch millions of lives all over the world. We thank You, Lord. We give You glory. We give You praise. Every faulty foundation, Lord, have mercy, O God, in the name of Jesus. Any foundation that has delayed us, O God, we plead Your mercy, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We plead Your mercy, O God. We plead Your mercy, O God. In the name of Jesus, O God, Baratama Santa Yanamada, Rabata, Labrado Shabata, Batana Badia Pashanta, Rabata, Rabato Shabataba, every foundation that is not of God, we cancel by the power of the blood. In the name of Jesus,
cancel by the blood.
Now, say this prayer after me. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Every foundation that has been constructed by the enemy in my life,
be destroyed.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Any foundation that has been constructed, by the enemy, of my soul. In the name of Jesus,
be destroyed
by the fire of God.
Blood of Jesus,
begin to erase every foundation,
that is not of God.
In the name of Jesus,
begin to erase.
Every satanic foundation, in the name of Jesus, any strong man attached to my foundation, be bound in the name of Jesus. Any strong man attached to my father's foundation,
my mother's foundation
that is fighting and delaying my life. I cancel the operation.
I cancel their works.
In the name of Jesus.
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 I cancel their thoughts.
I
cancel their plans.
I cancel their plans.
I cancel their strategies. In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Every foothold of the enemy. In my foundation. Be destroyed. By the blood of Jesus.
Every foothold.
In my foundation. I plead the blood.
I speak the blood.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Anything that has given the enemy
a legal ground
in my foundation,
I erase it
by the blood of Jesus.
I close
every closed door.
I close
every open door
by the enemy
in my life. In the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare.
Any battle
that is being waged because of my foundation, by the kingdom of darkness, I plead the fire of God.
I the fire.
I plead the blood of Jesus.
In
the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I defeat them. By the power of the blood. In the name of Jesus Christ. I declare. Every forces of Egypt. That has risen up against me. Because of my foundation. Begin to rise up against yourselves. In the name of Jesus. Every faulty foundation. Responsible for my delay. In the name of Jesus. I am coming out by fire. Every foundation that is fighting me, every foundation that is fighting my testimony, fighting my breakthrough, fighting my healing, fighting my transformation, delay me, O God. I enter my foundation. I send fire. I destroy my foundation with the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Any foundation that is not of God that has given access to the enemy to destroy things in my life, I declare this morning, I destroy the foundation, I destroy the blood, I destroy every evil foundation that is delaying me, delaying my breakthrough, delaying my job bearing, delaying my promotion, I cancel, I destroy by the fire of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Every problem that has come into my life, as a result of evil foundation, that is delaying me. Today, in the name of Jesus, I cancel it by the blood. I cancel it in the name of Jesus. I declare, O God, any blessing that belongs to me that has been trapped as a result of faulty foundations, today I release the judgment of God. I release the fire of God in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare every evil power source in my place of birth, connected to my foundation, be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed completely in the name of Jesus. All my blessings that have been locked up as a result of faulty foundation that is delaying my progress, today I claim my victory. I claim my testimony. I claim it by fire. Open your mouth and pray. We release every faulty foundation. We destroy by the blood. We declare in the name of Jesus, Father, there has been delaying my progress, delaying my breakthrough, delaying me, O God, in my going and in my coming. I release the judgment of God. I release the fire of God. I come out to God. I come out by fire. I expose their wickedness in the name of Jesus. Every foundation that is not of God, I come out by fire. In the name of Jesus, any delay in my life, no more. No more delay. In the name of Jesus, I pray speed. Speed in my life. Speed in my life. In the name of Jesus. We are still praying.
Yes, Lord.
That every evil agreement that has brought delay in my life,
that have brought delay in my life.
Today I cancel and I dissolve it in the name of Jesus.
See, I cancel and I dissolve it in the name of Jesus.
Every evil throne that has been fashioned. Connected to my foundation. To delay me. I release fire. I release the judgment of God. In the name of Jesus. May they fall by the sword. May they die by fire. May they fall by the sword. May they fall by the sword. In the name of Jesus. Any demonic programming, may they fall by the sword. Any satanic programming, may they fall by the sword. In the name of Jesus, fall by the sword. We release fire. We release judgment in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we declare any foundation that is preventing our promotion, we declare in the name of Jesus, let that foundation be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any foundation against our promotion, let the foundation be destroyed. In the name of Jesus Christ, let the foundation be destroyed. Let the foundation be destroyed. Open your mouth and pray. Let the foundation be destroyed. We come against every faulty foundation that is against our promotion. In the name of Jesus Christ, let the foundation be destroyed. Let the foundation be destroyed. Let the foundation be destroyed by the power of the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth and pray. Let the foundation be destroyed. We are still in prayer.
Yes, Lord.
We are sending the angel of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
To go into our foundation.
Yes, Lord.
To begin to destroy.
Yes.
Any altars in our foundation.
Jesus.
Any idol in our foundation.
Jesus.
Whatever idol worship. Angel worship.
Yes.
Or any kind of cult. Some of us, our parents belong to cult societies, secret societies, and they have raised satanic altars, satanic things, and those things are delaying us. Now they are dead and gone, but it is delaying us. We are praying that let the angel of the Lord go and begin to break in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Whatever they have buried in the sea, in the river, today we come against it. In the name of Jesus, we come against it by fire. Open your mouth and pray.
In the name of Jesus,
any evil foundation, we send the judgment of God. We send the fire of God. We pull down right now. We destroy their works. Amen. Power.
In the name of Jesus,
we send the angel of the Lord to pull down secret societies, secret altars. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray. La Pazalaba, La Pantalaba, 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 Whatsoever wherever my foot will tread, the Lord shall give to me for a possession.
Yeah.
And so make positive confessions.
Yes.
Say it, confess it until you see it.
Yes, Lord.
Don't be negative. Don't have a negative mind.
Mm.
Confess it until you possess it.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Because your progress is a determinant of your confession.
Yes.
Your progress is a determinant of your confession.
Yes, Lord.
And so if you want God to do something major in your life this year, learn how to make positive confessions. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are praying again, and we're going to make some confessions.
Yes,
and I want you to make confessions in the name of Jesus Christ. Hope your mouth begin to make confessions.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I confess with my mouth. I will walk into your promises. That Lord, every good thing that you have given for me, that you have assigned to come to my life, I shall receive it. I shall receive it this morning. Father, we will walk in your promises. We will dwell in your presence. We will receive your blessings. Father, my Father,
I make positive confessions.
Make positive confessions.
Now, say this after me. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive the goodness of the Lord.
I receive the goodness
in the land of the living.
In the land of the living.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Everything done against me.
Everything done against me.
This year 2021.
This year 2021.
To spoil my job.
To spoil my job.
Be destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Deal bountifully with me this year.
Deal bountifully with me this year.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Every blessing.
Every blessing
God has earmarked for me this
God
year.
God has earmarked for me.
I prophesy that it will not pass me
I
by.
I prophesy that it will not pass
in
me by.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
My blessing this year.
My blessing this year.
Will not be transferred to my neighbor.
Will not be transferred to my neighbor.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Every power.
Every power.
That wants to disgrace me.
That wants to disgrace
that
me.
That wants to steal my breakthrough.
I want to steal my breakthrough.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I cancel their operations in my life.
I cancel their operations in my life.
I prophesy.
I prophesy.
That every step I take this year.
That every step I take this
shall
year.
Shall lead me to outstanding success and miracles.
Shall lead me to outstanding success and miracles.
I declare this morning.
I declare this morning.
That I shall prevail with man.
That I shall prevail with man.
And with God.
And with God.
In the name of Jesus.
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 I claim favor on this day.
I claim favor on this day.
As I go out.
As I go out.
I receive favor.
I receive favor.
Favor before God.
Favor before God.
And favor before men.
Favor before men.
I receive favor.
I receive favor.
From my husband.
From my husband.
I receive favor.
I receive favor.
From my wife.
From my wife.
I receive favor.
I receive favor.
From my colleagues at work.
Colleagues at work.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I speak to the morning.
I speak to the morning.
That you morning.
That you morning.
On this day.
On this day.
You shall favor me.
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 I confess.
I confess.
That I am blessed.
That I am blessed.
Beyond measure.
Beyond measure.
I confess.
I confess.
That I am a victor.
That I am a victor.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I am the first.
I am the first.
And not the last.
And not the last.
I am a child of God.
A child of God.
I shall not die.
I shall not die.
But I shall live.
I shall live.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I am walking in power.
I am walking in power.
I have the life of God in me.
I have the life of God in me.
I have the sweet power of God in me.
I have the sweet power of God in me.
I am anointed.
I am anointed.
I have power.
I have power.
I have authority in Christ.
Authority in Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I tread upon serpent and scorpions.
I tread upon serpent and scorpions.
By no means shall anything hurt me.
By no means shall anything.
Thousand will fall at my right. 10,000 at my left.
10,000.
Only with my eyes I shall see the reward of the wicked.
The Lord the wicked.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
There shall be divine supply for me this year.
Divine supply.
Divine supply for my family.
Divine supply for my family.
Divine supply for my children.
Divine supply for
in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As they go to school, they will be excellent.
As they go to
in the name of Jesus Christ. Favor before my boss.
Favor before my
favor. Favor before my boss.
Favor before
in the name of Jesus.
In the name of
as I go out, the element will favor me.
As I go out,
the sun and the moon will favor me.
The
stars will favor me in the name of Jesus. The constellations will work in my favor. All things are working together for my good. in the name of Jesus Christ. That failure is working for my good. In the name of Jesus Christ. I am more than a conqueror.
I am more than a conqueror.
I am more than a conqueror. In Christ I can do all things. In Christ I am favored. In Christ I am blessed. In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Son of God, God bless you.
Thank you.
God richly bless you up in here. As I pray for you, I want you to stretch your hands.